All right. Hello, everybody, and welcome back once again for another episode of Emma Void's SteamWorld Heist Let's Play. So, last we left off, we'd picked up Ivonsky. We've got a few crew members now. And where were we headed next? Right. We're on our way to deal with these guys over here. Okay. And yeah, so for now, let's go ahead and go to this turret plans. Our competent captain and her courageous crew should take out this scrapper turret plans. Having fewer turrets around is never a bad idea, and destroying the plant's generator should be a breeze. Okay, well, fingers crossed. Let's see what we've got. That's the other thing. We should make sure we take the characters we want to take first. Level 1, level 0. Okay, so let's bring Ivonsky. And Sally. Get them both leveled up some. And what are we gonna give Ivonsky? Wait, hold up, what was that? He's got a Junkyard Thumper default. Okay. Here we go. I want to make a complaint about this wider type of explosion, said no one ever. We'll have to be careful of it since it's got friendly fire, though. The brass knuckles on Ivonsky. And let's go with maybe this rusty heavy armor for Sally. Alright, so I think everybody's looking good. Any new hats you want to make use of? Give this a shot. All right. Let's see here. Thank you. Monsky's got a different fire type. Let's give us a shot. Wow. Alright, gotta be careful with that. Okay, so Evansky, punch this guy. No way. There we go. Oof. Okay, so those guys blow up normally. So that's good to know. With the gun we've got equipped, it's move or attack. I forgot about that. That's okay. Try me with a blowtorch. How did you get past all my chums? Production mustn't slow down because of some prying cowbots. Luckily, I just shipped a full batch of turrets. Speaking of which, have a free sample of my craftsmanship. Activate turrets! Oh, hell. Oof. That's a lot of turrets. That's all your tricks. Oof. That's a lot of tricks. Try to take some of them out. Oops. No, that didn't quite work how I wanted it to. Thank you. bouncing shots like that is really fun, though. Yeah, that explosive range is pretty heavy. Never did check down here. Oops. Hey! There's probably some loot in here. Here we go. We've got our kill shot when he's out of this barrel up here. I think it's quite likely that reinforcements are going to come in through this door here. So let's set Ivanski up about there. Oh, unless they just don't bring any reinforcements, in which case that's cool too. Maybe not.
Okay.
Oh no, his hat. Definitely get out of here sooner rather than later, it looks like. Where did Ilonsky's hat go? Oh, it's all the way down here. Alright, well, you can't get it because it's behind the barrel. That's dumb. Alright, just leave it behind. I don't think it actually matters for anything. And mind the trajectory of its projectiles. I believe you have my staple. That's very silly. Frontier SMG. Alright. And, we need to sell something because we've got too much stuff. Ivansky's also a vanguard, like, that other guy. Can't remember his name. Dang! We couldn't foil their supply of turrets completely. Well, at least we now have fewer scrappers to worry about. We're close to that brutal crusher that's got TAP's contacts shivering in their hideouts. Yeah, and then let him shiver his timber instead. Let's shiver his timber. Oh my god. Alright, you bunch of dorks. Ivansky has been helping Seabrass getting salty joints moving again. A well-trimmed body will give better mood to sulky Seabot, yes? That's nice of you, Bogdan. He could really use some cheering up. Yeah! Alright. Before we go over there, though, yeah. We've got enough to check out this astral lawn area. A well-groomed lawn is a pure pride for its owner. Good thing we've mowed down all those scrappers. Backwater Bodega. No sign of advertising, but it looks like some kind of store. Whoever's running it has chosen an obscure approach on how to attract customers. Alright, well let's check it out. This is no place for loitering, so you'd better spend some money. Huh. Okay, Nana. Headhunter. Believed to be pre-owned by the contractor, a shady prize hunter. The letters BAM are etched on the stock. Huh. Interesting. Rusted light armor, small storage unit, large storage unit. Sushi side armor. What? interesting. Well, let's go ahead and pick up a storage unit, since we always need more of those. This rusty light armor. It might actually be nice to pick up, so let's maybe... Let's see. That gives us enough. 125. For now. Oh well. Alright, next time, I guess. Alright. Beat the brutes. Since no decent or indecent cowbot dare venture out in the colony as it is, someone has to stop this brutal crusher. So we're probably gonna need our highest level characters for this one, I imagine. So let's make sure we've got Seabrass along. And then who would be useful for our third? Ivansky, Valentine, or Sally? So we go with Sally in our third slot. Alright, so let's replace our sniper pistol with this Frontier Biggie. Instead of a carry-on Uzi for Sally. More damage. They both do more damage. Short-range burst fire. Pierce. No ricochets. Arcing projectile. Yeah, let's maybe try the stapler then. Might be useful. Seabrass his brass knuckles. Alright, I think that should be good. Well, that's good. Countdown right off the bat. Okay, that was pretty funny. Right, well. and an extra attack. Dang. Yeah, I definitely like this weapon. Wow. That was, pretty impressive, to be honest. Not sure if picking up hats actually does us any good, to be honest. But it's fun. You can go ahead and stay here for now. Alright, since we've only got a few moments until reinforcements come in, let's go ahead and get started towards... Oh! Interesting. Thank you. be darned, a walking smorgasbord of fresh parts for the grinder. And I just got this new cowbot arm and all. I'll scrap you, and our mom will use her awesome tech romantic powers to raise you back to a new life. In a better form than before, part of our family, an army of scrappers to rule the waters of the world. Come on, cousins, let's get these puny bots.
Well, that doesn't sound great. Let's see. Not quite as good as I was hoping, but oh well. Ooh, I want that hat though. That's not good. It's honestly not the best idea, but... Oh, let's see. There's our new hat. Good. Less nice. Oh no! Shoot. Well, that could have gone a bit better. Scrapper sidearm adds free action. Shoot a projectile that deals 3 damage. 2 uses per mission. Huh, nice. Frontier Shorty Mark 2. Awesome. Functional shoes are fall to winter essentials in any heister's wardrobe. Increases movement distance by +1. Scoped carry-on. This rapid sniper sports a quick burst and a full aim
laser sights. Nice. Scrapper cap and hat. An impressive hat, generating glances of awe from those less experienced. They don't hand out these on a whim, so wearers are probably rugged veterans. Rusty light armor. And Sally's parts. Scrapped crew won't get experience points and Earn's reputation is reduced. Sally's remains will be reassembled back on the ship. Right, so we gotta sell some stuff now. So got that Shorty Mark II. Yeah, that'll definitely be an upgrade on this. Let's go and get rid of it. Don't see us using those scrap grenades much, honestly. Let's go ahead and get rid of that rusty heavy armor. And I need to sell one more thing. The Frontier SMG is basically just a weaker version of the stapler, so let's go ahead and get rid of that too. Alright. Lost a point. Oh well. New ability? Area repair. Oh nice! Fully repair yourself and any inspired allies. Mend. Seabrass restores plus one health after every turn he has taken damage. Can never restore all damage taken that turn. Interesting. This scrapper boss has to be stopped. She's raising an army from parts of broken cowbots. My goodness, how's that even possible? Whoever she is, she's gotten her dirty witch claws on some sort of power. Takes some great technical prowess to manage what she's done, I'd say. Mixing people's parts like that, no wonder they're all bug nuts insane. We should head back to Taps and see if she's heard anything more about this techromancer. Oops. Alright, well, let's go ahead and have a chat with everybody. Good to see you reassembled again, Sally. Monkey did a fine job with it, I see. Would have gone a lot quicker if she'd only stopped squirming about so much, ma'am. Next time, start with my arms first. I can do the rest myself, I bet. The Royal Space Force is supposed to keep the law out here. Why are we doing their work? They should have handled these scrappers long ago, instead of riding our tailwind. Now they have their divers out here, wasting time drilling up the place. Better to clean up for them than after them, don't you find? Ivansky has been called bad names in life, but try to see good in all. Scrappers are making this hard. Taking on Royal Space Force, that is good. Using powers to raise dead parts is pure evil. Valentine doesn't have anything to say. That's okay. This explains how they got their volunteers. A steambot needs the freedom to choose their own parts as they grow, to create their own personality. Just slapping together new beings from various parts of parts of cowbots? Mixing already settled personalities can only lead to insanity. Alright, well, that explains what's been going on. Back to Lola's it is, ma'am. Ooh, although, Royalist Drilling Outpost. Royalist Diving Crew has claimed these cowbot asteroids for oil drilling. With this much scrapper activity close by, they're awfully well armed. Maybe leave them be for now. Yeah, that's a good point, I guess.
Turning in the fires are burning when the world takes around you. Your voice is talking all the time. And you live for sleeping, you've never slept because you cannot sleep. Gonna water with shine when you learn from all night.
Ah, seen character
elephants turning our style. So we build these wonderful automaton.
Can't go home no more. Not without my shipment, at least. A gang of bugnut crashing scrappers made off with my whole train. It was filled to the brim with supplies for the I'm having such a hard time keeping up with this accent. Space Force. I'll get disassembled for sure if I return with Sheldon. Say, you look like a tough bunch of steam bots. If you can get my train back, maybe we can make a deal about a reward later. Quite a difference, eh, Captain? Sure is, but I'm afraid it won't last for long. Scrapper Army is still growing. We need to take care of their leader, this Mother Techromancer. Thanks to you, some of my little steam birdies have surfaced again. Word is, a large smelter of a bot named Chop Sue is calling the shots in the Scrapper gang. She has a small chop shop closer to the core. Well, we need to go have a serious talk with her then. Better be careful, Captain. She seems crazy enough to start a war with the Royal Space Force. I can't help it, this is pretty awesome. That they just have these guys hanging out here as background music for this place. good stuff. Let's go take care of Chop Sue before she ruins the outskirts. And oh yeah, we've also got this space train. Hijacked space train drifting through the thin atmosphere. It might look serene, but anyone crazy enough to steal a royalist shipment should be handled with care. And how are we supposed to get... I guess we're gonna have to go through these guys over here. First off though, we'll check out a few places and do some shopping. Most of this stuff is pretty low level, to be honest. Big Bang. It's safe to say the world wouldn't be the same without it. Relatively speaking, it expands on you. Let's see, 5 to 6. So how's that compare with, It's about exactly the same, so, meh. Oh yeah, the scoped carry-on, how's that compare to, Alright, carry-on Uzi, we can get rid of that. That's easy enough. Okay. Easily concealed, fires two rounds. Total damage is the sum of both attacks. Alright, not really much in the way of stuff to buy at the moment, I guess. So real quick, let's open the way over here. Good riddance. Last thing we need out here is more gun-rattling royalists. Safe and secure. Let's maybe go deal with that train first. Eliminate all scrappers, get an epic swag, evacuate. So far, this area is too difficult, despite the fact that it seems like all the enemies have those grenade launchers. Expected. Successful. Alright, got some more loot, an armored top hat, hitched up region with a palette of rivets, feel comfortably rigged while promenading the battlefield like a true gentle pot. another scoped carry-on. We've already got one of those. And Frontier Thumper Mark III. Thump your foot to the rhythm of explosions, just make sure your crew doesn't get caught up in the jamming. Interesting. So we can go ahead and sell the Mark II then. And yeah, we've got two scoped carry-ons, definitely don't need that. Oh, I'll have to take care of it later though. Alright, well, I think that's it. probably enough for one episode. Well, actually, real quick, let's go check back in with the train driver. That old train driver sure wasn't kidding. These scrappers are insane. Seems only fair that we keep one grenade launcher for our troubles. Seems like this Chop Sue's turned her shop of horrors into a scrapper factory. I wonder how a smelter like her got a hold of such powers. Stealing and chopping up ships is one thing, but combining pots of different bots. She might have gotten away with her chop shop earlier, but the Royal Space Force won't ignore this. Time to harness that rage of yours, Gabriel. If this reanimating business is half as bad as I think, we're in for quite a fight. Yeah, what are we waiting for? Let's keelhaul the witch. Out, Bagger and Tagger, just like back at the farm. If there's something left when I'm done with her, you're welcome to it. Okay, you call dibs.
Bunch of nerds, all of them.
I've never been this close to the core before. It's nothing like farm life in the far reaches of the outskirts. This is more like a vacation paradise. Folk here are soft like tinfoil. The Techromancer can't be that tough if she's holding out here. Being close to the core is all but safe. You got the Royal Space Force right next door. Alright, and real quick, yeah, Valentine's got words for us too. This Techromancer sounds nasty, don't you find? Doesn't sound that bad, does it? I'm known as somewhat of a Techromancer myself. You get it? Tech-romancer? Because, you know, we're automatons. Yeah, that's bad. That's quite enough.
Yeah, that was, uncalled for.
Thanks for bringing it back to me. I just knew I could trust you. Now about that reward, we'll just hang on to a grenade launcher. One'll be quite enough too. The gang that took your shipment made that real clear. Disrespecting Her Majesty's property like that. This will surely bring the Royal Space Force down on the scrappers. Anyway, gonna be nice to see the little grand botch again. Just one more for the road, then I'll head on home.
All right, buddy.
So, thanks so much for watching, everybody. Be sure to check back next time, and until then, like, subscribe, all that jazz. Maybe check the notes down in the doobly-doo, where you'll find places to where you can chat with me or send me money or whatever. And also check out Steam Powered Giraffe, because I'm pretty impressed by how good they are. I haven't actually listened to much before playing this, so yeah. All right. See you all later. Bye!
Would you like to try a bumping leg through your veins? Or have a heart so when cold it starts rusting? Your brain takes unstopping voices talking all the time. And you live for feelings you've never felt because you cannot feel.